on the FWZ. FWZ presents first colossal event of 2019. FWZ, take the stage, rocks foundation. The main event saw the foundation take on the Briscoe brothers and Corey Taylor. Although Corey Taylor could not be found during this event, Corey Taylor eventually showed up completely different. Twists and turns led these men to back and forth action, with the Korean tech soon made, destroying anything that moved. That was until Cameron Black made an appearance to take Soon-Abe off of his focus. Kid Rock eventually sneaked into the match, scoring up to Jay Briscoe. This led to the Foundation winning this match and being declared the victor, with Kid Rock's measure successful. But the biggest shock was what came at the end of the event, as it was revealed by the FWC that Kid Rock now owns only 50% of the FWC. The other 50% is owned by billionaire and entrepreneur Elon Musk. What now lies ahead for the FWZ in these new waters? And does the complexion of the FWZ change now that there's been a major shift to power? What happens next?
Welcome, wrestling fans, to the FWZ. Welcome to FWZ Event Horizon. We are back in the zone, Chicago, Illinois, the United Center. We are days, weeks removed from our landmark event that was FWZ. Take the stage, Rocks Foundation. This day is a match that will be coming up later on tonight. The new FWZ Tag Team Champions, Tenacious D, going to take it on Puerto Rico's own Vicio Volodor. This is a non-title match that is scheduled later on for tonight. Also coming up as well, another title that changed hands at our landmark event. Paige Van Zant is now the women's champion, and she's going to be taking on the lady that lost that championship at that event. Celeste Bonin re-challenges Paige Van Zant for the women's championship. Hopefully there will be no interference from the beast that we saw come at that event. 1-on-1 match tonight for the women's championship. Many, many questions, little answers, but coming out to the ring now, the Foundation. They gotta be pretty happy with themselves. The main event of FWZ Take the Stage, Rocks Foundation. The Foundation, Jet Li, Soon-Abe, Jet Tornado, the heavyweight champion of the world. Going up against the Briscoe brothers, Corey Taylor. The Foundation were successful. They were victorious in that match, although not as clean as you thought it would be. Many, many interferences from that man himself, Kid Rock. There's the man that made a big impact at that event. I witnessed that man lift two men, the Briscoe brothers, over 400 pounds, and slam them right down to the mat. He also knocked the absolute piss out of Mark Briscoe as Mark Briscoe came from the top rope and smacked him right in the face. Strong words. Where does that man get off? I'm talking about reiterating his control of the FWZ, whether you like it or not. He is right. The man's got all the championships, the most powerful men of the FWZ. It looks like no one can stop this foundation. Tension brewing between these two men, only weeks removed. They were tag team partners. I guess Jay Briscoe hasn't taken that loss lightly. Isn't happy about that loss. Corey Taylor didn't show up at the beginning of that match. And almost a different person showed up in that main event. Jay Briscoe probably thought that that contributed to the loss.
This match is a tag team match, not contended for the tag team championship. Coming down the aisle, team number one, they're from downtown Puerto Rico. This is the combination of Garcia Ladron and Rondo Ladron.
Puerto Rico's own Eduardo Lebron, Garcia Lebron, Vicio Volodor. We saw them a few weeks ago on this program facing the new FWZ Tag Team Champions. Tenacious D winning those titles from Suchi Blade. And I tell you something, I had no idea that these men would put everything that they had into winning those championships. Suchi Blade using all the maneuvers they've known from being the best dojos around the world. But it was Jack Black who put on the claw onto Shinsuke. And that led to Tenacious D winning the Tag Team Championship. But here we have Vicio Volodor going against Tenacious D. This is a non-title match. And what an opportunity this will be for Vicio Volodor. Suchi Blade. Oh, what the hell is this? What? Oh, come on. What the hell is this? Suchi Blade beating up Tenacious D. Suchi Blade, you just... bad taste in your mouth after losing the tag team championships. Is it? I don't know if this match is going to continue or not. But these two men are getting straight back up. A sneak attack from Suchi Blade. What the hell was that about? I'm not sure if this match is going to continue. I guess it is. since Tenacious D are now on the other side of the ring. I guess it is Tenacious D. Sneak attack by Suchi Blade. What the hell is that damn problem? Suchi Blade clearly not happy about losing those tag team championships to Tenacious D. They were the ones that talked about Tenacious D not being serious week after week, talking about how much more wrestling ability they had to take on Tenacious D, but those words almost cost them, as it was Tenacious D that beat him in that ring. And here comes Jack Black now with Eduardo LeBron in the red, Garcia LeBron in the green. The interesting dynamic between this team. Eduardo LeBron in the red, a little bit smaller, 200 pounds. You see Garcia, a little bit more of a bigger frame on his upper body. The luchadors from Puerto Rico. And what a win it would be to pick up a win against Tenacious D, the tag team champions, with Vicio Volodor. And look at the absolute speed, the agility of Eduardo LeBron. That's one thing I love about Eduardo LeBron. He is fast and speedy, and that's what makes this dynamic of this team different. Garcia LeBron, a little bit different as he gets tagged into this match. A bit more of a groundsman, as you see, and that's what brings the different styles of this team. Garcia LeBron, a little bit more articulate with his moves inside the ring, and that's what makes it a lot different than common luchadors. We saw Vicio Volodor a few shows ago, going up against Silverlight and Gamma Black in their debut. What an impression it made. They did lose that match, but what an opportunity to be. And I can't believe the Tenacious D got straight up from that attack from Suchi Blade. Clearly Suchi Blade with a new attitude after losing that match to become tag team champions. There's no room for that kind of moves in this business. But Jack Black, Garcia LeBron, in the middle of that ring. Garcia LeBron with Vicio Volodor using smart technique of taking Jack Black and taking it to their side of the ring. Almost cutting off anywhere for Jack to tag in Kyle Gass's opponent. What a smart move from this team. Both brothers. And you know if you've got a brother, that is one relationship that is stronger than blood. And a big suplex from Garcia LeBron. And one thing that I love about Garcia LeBron, he is a big powerhouse. He has the strength to pick up his opponent and slam him down. Makes the ring rumble like an earthquake. And Eduardo LeBron, who is more of a high flyer, does some beautiful, beautiful moves. Technique is fantastic. And Jack Black tossing Garcia LeBron back in the ring. The first match after the event for Tenacious D as champions. Big suplex in from Garcia LeBron. Garcia LeBron's got the upper hand on Jack Black here. Who would have even thought that Tenacious D would even be in this business and even win the tag team championship? I mean, you can see, look at Jack Black, the size of Jack Black and to Garcia LeBron. There's at least 2 feet difference. Garcia's almost a mammoth of a man. Jack Black's got the tag to Carl Gass. Carl Gass is now in this match against Garcia LeBron. But a big power slam from Garcia LeBron runs down to Carl Gass. Doesn't look like the Tenacious D. Have much hope in this match. If you see the mammoth of a man, that is Garcia LeBron. Fantastic power that he has. There's some beautiful suplexes. Garcia LeBron now trying to almost get the tag for his brother. But each Jack and Kyle are almost cutting it off. But Kyle Gass is in this ring on his own now. Jack is on the outside after being in this match for a few minutes. Has got back to the ring apron for the tag for Kyle, but he's back now on the ring apron. Garcia again going to try and get Carl Gass a tag for his brother, but blocks it again. Almost an unstoppable task for Carl Gass and Jack Black to try and beat this team, as this team is very accomplished. But that was said the same about Suchi Blade, but Suchi Blade lost that match. Garcia Ramon up top now, second rope. Misses. That's Carl Gass now. Hopefully gets the other hand and a big right hand straight to Garcia Ramon. I don't even know how much damage that will do to a man like that, but it's worth a try. Carl Gass now going for the pin. First pin of the match. But Eduardo Ramon's in the match now to cancel it out, as Jack Black is now coming this ring. Jack Black taking Eduardo Ramon over. Garcia Ramon, Carl Gass, two men match now. Taking it back and forth. If you suit Tenacious D though, Garcia Ramon almost taking advantage of the beatdown that Suture Blade gave them before this match. So almost 20% less health that they would have in this match. But Garcia Ramon, you can tell, using those right hands just to dig into the shoulder blade, into the collarbone of Carl Gass. But Carl Gass now has come out of that submission move. You can even see the size difference between Carl Gass and Garcia Ramon. Garcia Ramon though, has been in this match for quite a while. He's going to tag to his brother, but his brother is up on the outside. Let's get back to that ring apron. Garcia, now Samoan drop from Garcia Ramon. I tell you something, Garcia Ramon could take these two men on his own. Not necessarily a good showing for the tag team champions, as Garcia Ramon lands the torso area onto the left shoulder of Garcia Ramon. You can see, look at that man. 6'6". And now he goes in for another submission as he uses that crossface onto Carl Gass. Carl Gass is near the bottom rope, so can leap out to grab that bottom rope, as he needs to do indefinitely. But you can see in the corner that Eduardo Ramon wants in this match. He wants a piece of the tag team champions. And now a big bookend from Garcia Ramon to Carl Gass. You can see that almost the power that comes out of that top area of Garcia Ramon, the big frame of that man, is a lot bigger than his brother. Carl Gass tags to Jack Black. Garcia Ramon tags to Eduardo Ramon. Eduardo Ramon now, the high flyer, who demonstrates some beautiful wrestling ability. But now Jack Black takes Eduardo when it's time for a spin. Holy mackerel, I don't want to be on the receiving end of that. Oh my god. I'd be dizzy as hell being on the receiving end of one of those. The crowd loving this match. Eduardo Ramon needs to get up. But he's probably got 360 vision. But Eduardo has counted it now. And this is where Eduardo Ramon now. Bam! Canadian Destroyer, as you can see. What a beautiful move that was from Eduardo Ramon. This is where his high-flying ability comes in and demonstrates for this team. He's taken the left arm and is now working on it, as he just jams that left hand straight to the mat now. I believe Vicio Volodor, one of the underrated teams of the tag team group in the FWZ. And you can see why, as you see Eduardo Ramon picking up Jack Black on that top turnbuckle. And this is where Eduardo Ramon thrives. Here we go. What's the high risk for move? Beautiful Spanish fly. Holy mackerel. That was a thing of beauty. We might as well call it the Puerto Rican fly for these two boys. Eduardo Ramon, high risk move. Shooting star press. Beautiful. Let's look at that once again. What a beautiful shooting star press. He got the talk on that as he lands on Jack Black. Could this be a win that these men need to put themselves in the tag team contention? Oh my goodness, and just a two count there. Jack Black barely surviving, as a near three fall was imminent. Beautiful high fly. You can see what I mean about the high flying moves. That's what makes this team so dynamic. Two different styles of a tag team. You have to prepare for two different people. That's another pin now, with a roll up pin from Eduardo Ramon. Two count fall. If I was an Tenacious D, you know, in the back of my head, I would be wondering if Suchi Blade is lingering around this arena tonight. Garcia LeBron now tightens this match, as now he's going to go top rope. Garcia LeBron famous for that patented beautiful elbow drop. Let's see him fly. Here he goes. And he connects. Beautiful Randy Savage-like elbow drop right to the damn chest of Jack Black with a pin. Comes into play once again. And a new two fall again. Eduardo LeBron in this match. Now with another Canadian Destroyer. Thing of beauty as Eduardo LeBron goes for another pin. And just another kick out there once again. Jack Black with Eduardo LeBron on the outside. And he drives his head straight into the ring apron. Holy mackerel, that is damaging enough. Look at that as he just jams him straight into the apron. My goodness. Jack Black driving Eduardo LeBron straight into the ring apron. That'll send you crazy. Eduardo LeBron now drags Jack Black back into the ring. Eduardo LeBron now has Jack Black as a top, as he's going up top with a DDT. That is the beautiful agility of Eduardo LeBron as he goes in for a pinfall once again. No, another two count. What are these two men going to do to put this team away? And a beautiful drop kick from Jabba. Who would have thought the Tenacious D would have this much energy, this much determination when they're going against teams like Vicio Volodor and Suchi Blade? And a big body drop from Jack Black once again. Kyle Gass is now in this match as Jack Black takes Kyle Gass and throws him for a splash. And that's at least 300 pounds coming at you. Not necessarily muscle. As Kyle Gass with a big right hand straight to Eduardo LeBron. Holy mackerel, that was a big, big right hand. And now a pinfall attempt as Garcia comes and saves his brother. I mean, the insanity of now Jack Black has the claw on Garcia LeBron, but it doesn't matter as he's not the legal man. Garcia's rolled out of the ring. This could be a dangerous moment here for Vicio Volador if these two men can now corner Eduardo LeBron in the corner and get the pinfall submission for this match, as his brother is out. That's the more dangerous of the two. But now the claw from Kyle Gass. It's Eduardo LeBron. This is where an all-in one for Suchi Blade at Take the Stage Drugs Foundation. Is this where Eduardo's going to tap out? Eduardo hanging off for dear life. He's got those big right hands onto the face, onto the skull of Eduardo LeBron. Eduardo is in a whole lot of trouble and needs to get to a rope. You can see him as he's just locking it in. All the blood rushing to his head. He is scraping around, but he has not submitted and he needs to do anything that he can to get out of this move. Oh, wait a minute, he's using those right hands to chuck it out once again. Eduardo, unbelievable, up top, beautiful, lands in there, but I think he caught it the wrong way with his legs. I didn't think that was the way that Eduardo thought it was going to go, as he goes to try and do a hurricanrana, but he landed wrong. But you can see Kyle Gass sneaking round to Jack Black, as now Jack Black's in this ring against Eduardo with a beautiful drop kick. Eduardo needs a tag against Garcia LeBron. What a match this is going to be, and what a match this is, as now Jack Black . Who knew these two men had all of our heart and determination to take it to Suchi Blay or Vicio Volodor. Should I say, here comes a roll-up pin. One, two, no. Garcia comes in to save his brother once again. Carl Gass is now back in here as well. My goodness, what a match this is. Vicio Volodor using all the skill that they have, but Tenacious D showing the drive that they had that won them the tag team championships. Jack Black went to go sneakily after Garcia LeBron, but Garcia LeBron again uses his feet to say to Jack Black, I don't think so, get on with this match. Eduardo LeBron almost seeing some fatigue now in this match as he's going to take Jack Black up again. You see he's a bit more sluggish than before when he took Jack Black on the top rope. Is he going for the Puerto Rican fly once again? I believe that he is. Here we go. Look at that 630 degrees rotation. And that is the speed, the beautiful agility of Eduardo LeBron. These men need to pick it up though. We need a pinfall. We need a submission in this match. And here's the claw. Here is the claw once again. Eduardo LeBron has already been in this claw from Carl Gass, but Jack Black once again has got it locked in. He's tapped. He's gone. Tenacious D win this match. Tenacious D did fantastic in this match, considering they got attacked by Suchi Blay at the beginning of this match. However, take nothing away from Vicio Volodor, still a team that I believe have a lot to give to the FWZ. Garcia LeBron showing the power and the beautiful agility from Eduardo LeBron. But that is where it happened, that is where it came to an end. Tenacious D locking in the claw once again. Oh, what the hell are they doing here again? Oh, for God's sake! Suchi Blay coming in again, attacking these men after what they did in the beginning. Come on, give these guys a break. What is your damn problem? You lost. What? Oh my God. Do my eyes deceive me? That is the Lucha Brothers. Rey Fénix. Pentagon Jr. Coming after Suchi Blay. Rey Fénix with the Canadian Destroyer. Pentagon Jr. coming in with a package pile driver. These two men sticking it to Suchi Blay coming out of nowhere. Holy mackerel, the Lucha Brothers here in the FWZ. More tag teams entering the FWZ. As these men stare down Suchi Blay, you got another team you got to worry about. Welcome back to FWZ Event Horizon. I cannot believe what I just saw. Suchi Blay double teaming Tenacious D again. And out of nowhere, the Lucha Brothers coming on the stage to save Tenacious D. This is where Rey Fénix came in with the Canadian Destroyer and Pentagon Jr. with a package pile driver. We've got a new tag team in the FWZ, and it's more teams than the tag team champions now going to worry about. Later on tonight, we're going to be hearing from Youth, who shocked the world when he turned on his tag team partner. We deserve an explanation for this heinous attack. Taking a steel chair and destroying the left arm of Jack. He's got a lot of explaining to do. This is our first match on FWZ Take the Stage Rocks Foundation. Brendan Fraser, Frank Ocean, Ice Cube, and even Dr. Phil was in the arena, in the house. Number one contender to become the Celebrity X champion. The number one contender for the Celebrity X champion. Ice Cube was eliminated first after a big shock. Hell, even Ice Cube was in there shorter than Dr. Phil was. But Frank Ocean eliminated Ice Cube, and Frank Ocean come with a big old kick straight to Dr. Phil's face, and Dr. Phil was out of here. That left Frank Ocean and Brendan Fraser, who was going to eliminate the other one over the top rope. But it was Brendan Fraser that took Frank Ocean over the top rope to give him the opportunity to challenge the Celebrity X champion Jet Li for a future championship title shot. Brendan Fraser in the house tonight as the guest of Jim Carrey on In Living Color. Oh, God. What? Hey, Kevin Hart is in the building. Well, I guess that's that. We might have a future match between Kevin Hart and Dr. Phil. Here comes Here comes the biggest piece of crap in the FWZ. I've known Nuke and Jack for almost 10 years, one of the best tag teams in the FWZ, and I have no idea why you turned on his brother, his friend, his tag team partner. You better come up with it. Hey, you know what? There isn't even a good excuse. What, is he going to say anything? He's leaving this ring without even saying a word. What a joke. We'll see Briscoe on that stage. Had a confrontation with Corey Taylor. Almost blaming Corey Taylor for losing that match in the middle. Oh my god. What the hell just happened? Does anybody know what the hell just happened back there? Well, I guess I gotta move on quickly, but someone needs to check what the hell just happened back there. Oh, they don't have that match here. Celeste Bonin is going to be taking on Paige Van Zant for the FWZ Women's Championship. Celeste Bonin was the former champion who lost it in that fatal four-way match, the Four Corners match. And FWZ takes the stage, Rockstar Nation, Lucy Liu, Zoe Saldana, and Paige Van Zant, who got the submission on Lucy Liu. And here she is, the new Women's Champion. Paige Van Zant. But the number one story coming out of that match though, and that event, is Paige Van Zant got targeted by a woman named The Beast, who just took out Paige Van Zant with a powerbomb. Paige Van Zant has got to focus here. Not think about that moment, but think about this match.
This match is the result of the FWZ Women's Championship of the World. We're called to the finish with Claire Miller. Introducing participant number one to my right, the former champion from Houston, Texas. This is Celeste Bonin. And the other participant in this match, the opponent, currently the reigning FWZ Women's Champion of the World, from Portland, Oregon, this is Paige Van Zant.
Paige Van Zant's first title defense against the former champion Celeste Bonin. Celeste Bonin is going to want to try and get that championship back, since technically she was not the one that got pinned or submitted at that event. It was Lucy Liu. So now this is hopefully going to be the time that she tries to regain it. But what a mountain of talk she's got to do in getting it from Paige Van Zant. A small roll-up package pin already here by Paige Van Zant. Just a one count here. We've known before from previous shows on FWZ Event Horizon, these two ladies put on one hell of a show, as they are not afraid to get snug with each other with those fists that they use. Those both women putting it all in the ring. And Paige Van Zant now being tossed out of the ring. The question remains, was it just the opportunity that she had to put away another FWZ woman? And it was just a one trick from Paige Van Zant to take that championship, since she didn't actually pin or submit the champion. And will Celeste Bonin take the championship back due to being the real champion? Or was Paige Van Zant good enough to be the champion and be the rightful champion? Celeste Bonin, as you can see, just jacking in some right hands. This is what these ladies do best. Taking it to each other. We had this match a few shows ago, but it was interrupted by Lucy Liu and Zoe Saldana. So this match really being and showing who's the better lady of these two. Celeste Bonin's got Paige Van Zant as a crossface. One thing that I know about Celeste Bonin, she has been in this business for over 10 years. That's a pinfall count here. Paige Van Zant kicking out. She's probably one of the best women that we have in the FWC in all-round ability. But one thing not to take away from Paige Van Zant, she is a tremendous striker, and she is a tremendous submission specialist, as you saw winning that championship by putting Lucy Liu. That Paige mission. Just choking out the opponent by using the arms and cutting out all oxygen towards the opponent. But here again, you see Paige Van Zant there with that beautiful suplex that she does, that only she knows how. Just a two count fall. This could be a match that tests Paige Van Zant's ability and almost all the kind of opponents she can do. But there's a similar story here to almost the tag team championship, in that people almost putting down Paige Van Zant. Another pinfall here again. Two. No, just a two count fall. People almost putting these men and women down, which almost fuels them more to give their hunger and increase it for the championship. And Paige Van Zant now knocking the head on the turnbuckle of Paige Van Zant. That'll knock you crazy. But all the doubts of people who said that she could do it has proved them all wrong, as she, just like Tenacious D, holds the championship. The one thing though that is surprising is, but wait a minute, we got ourselves a one leg lock from Paige Van Zant onto Celeste Bonin. This is where Paige Van Zant thrives, with that submissions that I was saying about. Celeste Bonin, in a world of trouble, needs to get to a rope. Very, very close to that bottom rope, but Paige Van Zant's almost pulling back the ankle, pulling back the quad. And Paige Van Zant is knocked out as Celeste Bonin kicks out. That is a lot of power you've got to do. Celeste Bonin's got to at least be 180 pounds. Paige Van Zant is only just 120, 125. And that is a big difference maker there, as Paige Van Zant there with the Special Olympics suplex. And that is what I'm talking about. That makes Paige Van Zant so stiff with those moves. One, two, no. Celeste Bonin is still in this match. Celeste Bonin now has a backwards powerbomb from Paige Van Zant to Celeste Bonin. Paige Van Zant is looking real good. She's looking real strong in this match, as she signals that she's going to break something. But Celeste Bonin having none of it. And this is where we showcase two of the top best athletes of the FWZ, Celeste Bonin and Paige Van Zant. Considering Paige Van Zant is only 25 years old. And here she goes, knocking the head on the turnbuckle. My goodness. It's got to be the youngest. Oh, wait a minute. Celeste Bonin with a Samoan drop. Abandoned move Celeste Bonin is now signaling Paige Van Zant to get up. Here we go here. Modified Samoan drop there. And the pinfall. Are we going to have a new FWZ Women's Champion? And no! Paige Van Zant still in this match as she gets straight back up. These two women, strong as they come. You ain't gonna catch them in the kitchen making biscuits, that's for sure. Both of these women are now fighting on the outside. But we do have a count in this match of 10. So referee now at a higher count. But both these women come back into the ring. Big clothesline from Paige Van Zant. Paige Van now has Celeste Bonin in the corner. She uses almost the interesting maneuver. She uses just the elbow of her right hand and just almost paintbrushes Paige Van Zant right in the corner. But Paige Van Zant is now got the upper hand. She's feeling the momentum. This could be the end. Once again going for that special round modified suplex. Again, she's lugged it in twice. This is going to be the end for Celeste Bonin, as she's now been hit twice with that move. Oh no, not again. No. Oh no. The beast is here. Come on, we got a match going on. Two women are putting all of it in to be the world's champion. Oh Christ. We met this lady at FWZ Take the Stage Rocks Foundation after Paige Van Zant won the championship, and she's now interrupted this match. Women, get the hell out of there. You can see like the murderous look on her face. But both of these two women are now up and they're aware of what's staring them in the face. There ain't a woman you want to mess with. Well, Celeste Bonin looks like she's going to take it to the Beast. Oh no, the Beast got her up for a powerbomb! Wrong move by Celeste Bonin. Oh, and as you can see, the Beast looking up into the ring, Paige Van Zant. Oh, wait a minute, the ring announcer couldn't even finish. This is a no contest, but the Beast now has Paige Van Zant for a powerbomb! Two times in a row! Oh, wait a minute, she's got it back up for another one! Oh, come on, stop this, what the hell? Oh my goodness! That is the FWZ Women's Champion, who has been made a joke out of again, twice in a row. This Beast, the Beast, is a force to be reckoned with. Who the hell is going to stop her? And what the hell is her plan here in the FWZ? Oh, wait a minute, we're back here backstage and our limo has just pulled up in the bunker. Who the hell is in this? Who is that? Oh, wait a minute. What? What the hell is Elon Musk? Elon Musk is here in the FWZ. Is he coming out to the ring? He's coming out to the ring! We're approaching the end of the FWZ event horizon, and look who is here. Elon Musk is here in the FWZ. We saw at the end of that colossal event, Take the Stage Rockstar mentioned that that man owns 50% of this whole damn wrestling company. This is almost a natural disaster that Kid Rock did not see coming. What is his plans here for the FWZ, considering at the start of this program, Kid Rock asserted that he had 100% control of this whole business. Hopefully he can shed some light on what the hell is going on around here. That is what I'm talking about. Hallelujah. Two announcements already. Brendan Fraser is going to be taking on Jet Li for the FWZ Celebrity X Championship next week on our next show. And Cameron Black is reinstated. Wow. My goodness, I remember that all those years ago. I didn't even forgot about that. Jet Tornado, first championship match for the World Championship in two shows' time. Holy mackerel! Three blockbuster announcements. A world championship shot from Matt Sydal, who's coming back to the FWZ. Cameron Black is reinstated. And Brendan Fraser going to take on Jet Li for the Slam X championship. Next show, the Foundation is not in control anymore.